I was walking in the street and a guy, he just told me that he was going to help me to find a job. And I believed him, but it wasn't true. And when we get to the place that I was gonna ask for the job, they put something in the beverage, and I just start to sleep.
I started off in the CIA and then went into the Department of Homeland Security, where they asked me to start a child crimes group. Initially I said, no, I can't do that. I got kids, I just can't imagine having to witness that kind of thing. My boss, he said, we need you to do this because this is so hard. You have a religious background that's gonna give you the foundation so that you can deal with this. But I didn't know if I could actually do it. Then I thought of one of my great heroes of American history, Harriet Beecher Stowe. She was confronted with fighting for human freedom, and she didn't know what to do either, being just one person. But she knew she could write. So she wrote a book, Uncle Tom's Cabin. Sold over 19 million copies, inspired the nation. She shined a light on the darkness of slavery and created a movement. People got on board. And slavery began to end. And though I never thought I could be like her, I could at least learn something from her and try. I've been doing this ever since. Everything from child pornography to child trafficking to child sex tourism. I've worked, domestic, overseas, a lot of cyber, computer crimes. The first case I worked was absolutely life-altering for me. It was a little boy who had been trafficked along with his sister back and forth from Mexico, and they were being raped. There's a video of this little boy being raped. The monster, like, he would take videos of it, and we come across this video and watching this little boy, and we had to watch it. That's one of the stomach-turning things. You've got to watch it to find clues. Where is he? What's in the background? Is there anything we can identify? At the scene of rescue, and as things were kind of, the dust was settling, they realized that they were rescued, and this little boy jumps into my arms, and I have this moment with him, just crying with him. And he says to me, I don't belong here. And I thought, can I do this? Can I possibly continue in a job? It forces me to see this again and again. And ultimately, I decided that it was that experience that actually, instead of dissuading me, actually in the end encouraged me. And that's all I will do. That's all I'll do for the rest of my career, as far as my life. Working for the United States government has been great, but the sad reality is that the vast majority, probably over 90% of those kids out there who are being trafficked, fall outside the purview of the United States or any other developed nation that has a plan, that has the resources. And so it occurred to me, maybe it's my responsibility to leave the government and take the tools I've learned and apply them as a private individual, as a private organization. And we created it. It's called Operation Underground Railroad, a foundation, a legal organization to go after these kids and work with the foreign governments that need help. Empower them, bring them the tools, make them the heroes. Teach them how to continue rescuing kids long after we're gone, to create a revolution against this great plague that infects the entire world, this plague of child trafficking.
Yo fui víctima de trata de personas cuando tenía 14 años. Mis primas me llevaron a Tijuana. Yo soy de Córdoba, Veracruz. Me llevaron a Tijuana diciéndome que iba a trabajar en una fábrica de ropa, que podría continuar con mis estudios, a lo cual no era cierto. Era trabajar sexualmente y pues la verdad no es nada padre estar ahí, estar 2 años y medio.
When I was an agent in the government, there was this informant who was able to get information and get access to suffering children in ways that others just could not. We call this guy Batman, that's his code name. Words can't express how grateful I am for Batman. He is an absolutely integral part of this whole process. He can go places and do things that others, including myself, can't. We call him Batman because he works in the dark. He finds the traffickers, and more importantly, he finds the children that the traffickers are selling. The guy's a miracle. He has the ability to mix and mingle and connect with evil in ways that are almost incomprehensible. I'm proud to say that we did have some successes together. We also had a lot of frustrations. But I told them to be patient, that I'm working on something. The creation of a private organization that would work not only with the US government, but with all governments. We could take the tools we've learned and plug them into any jurisdiction and save kids all around the world.
I spent the better part of 15 years laundering money for drug cartels all over Latin America. When my life changed, I had been at a high point using a lot of laundered money. I was the funder of two hotels totaling over $50 million. I was living on 9 different passports. I had 9 different passports, Canadian passports. When I'd go down to these countries to pick up the money, you know, I was just out of control. I was drinking, I was using drugs, doing all the things that I'm so against now. When I realized what God was calling me to, I was sitting in an orphanage that is in the middle of a red light zone in Mexico that was filled with the sons and daughters of the prostitutes. And I was talking to a 10-year-old and a 12-year-old girl, and they were sharing the stories of what had happened in their life. One of those girls, Lupita, was 10 years old at the time. And as she was sharing, I asked her, you know, what about your mom? And she said, well, my mother was the one that would allow her boyfriends to come to our house and touch me. And she would put pornographic movies on, and I would have to do whatever was happening in those movies with her boyfriends. The next girl started to share that her life fell apart when she got raped, which became a regular thing in her life because her mother was a prostitute in the red light zone. And it was extremely convicting because her mother was a prostitute in the same red light zone where I used to spend nights and sometimes weeks. And I went home that night. I was living in a crack hotel. That's where I was working out of at the time. And I went back to the hotel that night, and I literally cried myself to sleep because I realized that what if I had hired this girl's mother for the night, and because I was with the mother, she was left alone, unprotected, and was raped. I was suicidal. September 15th, 2005. I had a razor blade ready to take my life. And I had heard about God, I had heard about Jesus. And I literally that night, as I was ready to take my life, I made a Hail Mary prayer. And I called out to a God that I didn't believe in, to a Jesus who I didn't believe in. And I thought even if those two existed, that they wouldn't care about somebody like me. And, you know, God responded. I heard his voice that night, and he literally called me to do what I'm doing now. I mean, I knew that night that the rest of my life would be spent rescuing and saving these little girls.
In a neighborhood just not far from here, this girl was taken by a family member. This was the most tragic part of this, and we see this often. Her aunt lived with her and her mother, and they thought they were a happy family. Well, the aunt, turns out, had been hired by an American for months on end. They brought this little girl, Maria, to his home. They drugged her up. She held her down, her aunt, and just, she was raped again and again and again. Part of our mission is we stay with these kids. We don't just save them and walk away. We stay with them. We make sure they get the healing that's required. And we got Maria into a safe place. And now we're following up. It takes time. The healing, the damage these monsters do to kids is just overwhelming. It's unbearable. Pero cómo está todo?
Está bien.
Sí. ¿Cómo te sientes?
Por una parte triste porque todo lo que me hicieron ese americano, mejor dicho, desapartó a mi familia. Y ahora lo que tenemos es vivir preocupada porque mi tía está libre y ella llama y amenaza.
El que tenía el poder para hacer daño está encarcelado.
Pero mi tía ahora llama y ella dice que ella con quien se la va a desquitar es conmigo y con mi mamá, entonces. Y ella se siente triste porque yo a ella le echo toda la culpa y para mí ella es la culpable de todo lo que a mí me hicieron. Y
la verdad es que le engañaron a tu mamá. Ella no sabía. Fue difícil para ella creer lo que estaba pasando realmente. Sería difícil para cualquiera, ¿no? Pensar que una tía podría hacer algo así, tan terrible.
Lo que tú pasaste fue algo terrible. Entonces yo sé que iba a tomar tiempo. Fue casi un año que estuvimos aquí. Casi un año ha pasado. Para mí, cuando te vi, cuando entramos y te vi muy contenta y feliz. No como la otra vez. ¿No? La otra vez fue más difícil, ¿no? Pero esta vez te vi más contenta.
Porque yo no lo demuestro. Yo no, aunque ande como yo ande, pero no. Siempre trato de hacer lo posible por andar bien, no andar así, como siempre he caminado y trato de no recordar nada, pero
no, va a tomar tiempo. Lo bueno es que dar gracias a Dios que está libre. No tiene novio, ¿sí? No quiero que tenga, no, ya muy jovencita para tener novios. ¿Sí?
No tengo.
Nunca, nunca. Hasta los 25 años puedes empezar a salir con muchachos. Ok. actually worked in Colombia years ago, worked with Colombian officials, and I got a sense that they were serious about this. Cartagena happens to be a place where travelers come in and out. Cruise ships come in and out. It is a high trafficking area in that regard. And so it made sense to start there. And so we hit the ground running with this government that was very supportive and interested in what we were doing. And Operation works, first and foremost, by finding the bad guys, and finding, more importantly, finding the kids that the bad guys are enslaving.
Jump around so it doesn't see what's going to come up.
Yeah.
How are you?
Yeah.
We have to pretend to be sex tourists, talking to taxi drivers, sitting on the beach and waiting for a vendor to come up and start offering us everything from drugs to adult women, and eventually it comes up. Well, how about children? At that point, we tell them that we want to have a party. We want to have a sex party, and we want children to be the objects of lust for this party.
Mañana yo te voy a explicar, entre más fresquitas, mejor. Es de esos americanos viejos, son locos, les gusta hacer cosas con niñas, entonces.
Soy Tim, ¿hablas inglés?
Está bien, tú le das a ella la plata, yo no le hago a ella.
No.
Yo eres mi amigo.
Exactamente, usted me da a mí, yo le pago a ella.
We rent a house that's conducive to this kind of a party, and the traffickers deliver.
Él es loco.
No, está loco por el dinero.
Amigo, ¿qué pasó? Bueno, escúchame, es una despedida de soltero. Es el gerente de la compañía, y a él le gustan así, como te dije, le gustan pequeñas, frescas.
They're going to leave at 10:30, go to this barrio where there's 9 prostitution bars together. And the guy has already talked to a guy there who says that the 12-year-olds are not in the bars, but right outside on the streets, close to it. And we're going to go meet this guy tonight, and then he's going to pick the 5 or 6 girls that he's going to bring for us to the party, 12 to 14-year-olds. That's the plan.
Homeboy Marco shows up because he wanted $20,000 to go run over there. He wanted to talk to the girls right now to make sure tonight they're going to be there. And I'm like, yeah, no problem. I gave him $50,000. I'm like, now how old are these girls? He's like, oh, you know, 13, 15, all of them.
Right on here.
And it's perfect. We got 3 angles.
Triangulated,
audio, video, everything.
Oh, the physicals now love that.
6:10. Okay, call me when you're in the van heading here. And I'll meet you at the restaurant. Peace. There you go. He's got all the girls, so he's waiting for the van.
Oh.
So that's 8 guaranteed. Done.
Beer everywhere.
Yeah.
Everywhere, everything. And just say, hey, relax with us. We're gonna
liquor, a couple bottles of rum, some beer.
Heineken?
Heineken. Pull over there.
There you go. Oh, got me, and I'm a non-drinker.
I'm a non-drinker.
I'm
really am. I've never had a Cibalo in my life.
You're not kidding.
I'm dead serious. But
in your life?
In my life, I've never had a sip of beer. Never. I never will. But it does serve a purpose for me, and that is to give me a disguise. It makes the bad guys feel comfortable with me, and that is protection for me.
We'll be like, okay, that's good. I'm comfortable. You're gonna, I'll bring the boss down now, and I'll have someone go get Dale, and he'll be coming down, and like he looked at the girls, like we got a surprise in the room for you, and then he'll be like, woo, scream like, yeah, and then he'll come down, and then he'll give us a second opportunity for them to emphasize again to him what these girls are gonna do, like, cause he'll come down and say, hey, remember what happened in Guatemala? And then I'll be translating, to the bad guys. I'll be saying, yeah, he's worried about Guatemala. Remember I told you guys. And then they'll be like, no, these girls are going to bleepity, bleepity. They're going to, it just gets them more excited to reemphasize all the dirty. And then, all right, let's go. And then the sign will be my hat off. I'll go like this and scratch my head. And he'll be sitting here and say, go. Go. And then, boom, the door's off the hinges, whatever. So we're gonna save some kids in a couple hours. It's going to be awesome.
For these things, we always pray. So, we're going to say a prayer and then we're going to offer.
Sure. Father, we just come to you now, Lord. We just thank you that you're a God filled with love, you're a God filled with mercy and grace. And we lift this up. When the van gets there, hang there until I tell you to come to the restaurant, okay? Bye.
Yeah, but this is cutting close, dude. We're 535.
What? What about these little kids? This is gonna make them look horrible. Then the chance is that they look. They just called it off.
This is why I operate Black Third of Time. This is exactly why I do it.
How can you possibly turn back into the streets? I don't understand it.
Is there still a possibility that's going to happen?
It's got
from Fernando's standpoint?
There's always a possibility.
Fernando hung up and said, I'll call you back. If somebody came in, he said, I'll call you back.
I've never seen a thing put together so well as this thing. I mean, this thing is a freaking silver platter. Why would they not want to do that? That's always my question. Why would they not want
to? Just do it, and even if it doesn't work, the prosecution doesn't work, save the kids.
Never gotten it to this point where 20 minutes before go time, they say no.
I think we just tell them that someone called the cops because they were playing music too loud. The boss got freaked out because the cops showed up and he called everything off.
we'll just tell them, sorry guys, stand by. We're gonna try again. We'll be in contact. Let's keep your phone number. It's bad luck this time, but maybe next time. It's off. Everyone's gone home. The lawyers went home, the cops went home. It's over.
Yeah, we got guys here telling us they're gonna kill us, so we need to get pictures.
What?
Guys, those last guys at the beach are here saying they're gonna kill us.
Who's gonna kill us?
The guys that got in the house.
Why?
They want money for going around looking for girls.
Get a picture of the face.
I'm gonna go get this.
Guys from the beach, they were bringing us kids. They wanted more money. And so they showed up at our house, and they knew where we were because they actually helped us get the house. They showed up, tried to extort us, and threatened to kill us. The sooner that we get over here with guns, the better. Maybe even send some more folks over with guns, just in case the threat is real.
Oh boy.
En una semana, en 15 días.
Ok, entonces regresemos. Regresemos.
Estoy apenado contigo.
No.
Por mi país, lo siento.
Está bien. Yo entiendo estos problemas. Mire, dígame honestamente, ¿es posible que regresemos y hacerlo?
Si es posible, volver.
¿Es posible que otro fiscal reciba el caso?
Sí, otro fiscal hacemos.
¿Por qué?
Pero mira, con más tiempo. Hay que hacerlo con más tiempo. O sea, y la operación...
Mire, ya tenemos los contactos. Hey. Están muy felices ahora.
Sí.
Regresemos. Bueno, regresemos en un mes o dos meses. No,
un mes.
When the operation in Cartagena failed, it was honestly one of the most depressing days of my life. It was unfathomable that we had to watch 11 kids leave our presence and go back into the streets with these traffickers. And there was nothing I could do about it. I found some solace in a church, a cathedral, downtown Cartagena. I went there and learned about the first abolitionist in the Americas, Pedro Claver. This was a guy who had a lot of failed attempts at eradicating slavery himself, but he didn't give up. He continued throughout his life to be an abolitionist. I was able to receive some comfort from the father who ran the church, who understood the evil of slavery.
Padre, estamos en este catedral tan, tan bonito y aquí tenemos el cuerpo de este, del santo Claver. ¿Por qué es el santo de los esclavos? ¿Qué hizo él para recibir este honor?
Me haces una pregunta muy importante y muy compleja. ¿Por qué Pedro Claver es el esclavo de los esclavos, el que se adelantó a su tiempo para proclamar una solución a la esclavitud? El problema de los esclavos se identifica, diríamos, con el padre Claver, porque él lo llamamos hoy el defensor de los derechos humanos. Y esa palabra, derechos humanos, es del siglo XX, siglo XXI. Y él vivió en el siglo XVII. ¿Cómo puede un hombre del siglo XVII intentar una solución a un problema que todavía en el siglo XXI no lo hemos podido solucionar?
It's a problem that has never truly been eradicated. But that does not mean that we shouldn't move forward, that we shouldn't continue to fight. I've sent Batman deeper into Latin America. He's in Ecuador, working to see what we can find there.
Acabo de salir de esta pesadilla hace casi 2 meses. Fui rescatada en la zona de la Merced por personas que están comprometidas con salvar a gente como nosotras y que no pensé que hubiera gente que se preocupara por personas que son explotadas sexualmente y...
We're on our way to Haiti. Thousands, thousands upon thousands of children are fatherless, are motherless. It's a place where traffickers come to take children, to kidnap them, to push them into sex slavery, to push them into slave labor. There's another reason we're going to Haiti, and it's personal to me. I have a friend there. His name is Gessno. He lost his son, Gardy. He was kidnapped and trafficked. And I made a promise to Gessno when I was an agent that I would do all I can to find his son. And so we're going there. We're gonna find this little boy. And we're gonna find the traffickers who did this to him. Gessno is an amazing man. What he does for a living is he helps children. He runs one of the most successful orphanages in Haiti. Hundreds of kids come in and he seeks homes for them. The children there, they are happy. They love him. He's a father figure to them. In fact, ironically, the reason his son was kidnapped was because he was so successful at building an orphanage that people mistakenly believed he was a rich man.
All of us are convinced involved in Haiti, they're still there, but where?
The last time somebody thought they saw Gardy was in La Calle, right?
Yes.
So he could be there.
Yeah, he could be there, he could be in Popas too. Hidden somewhere.
So it was the nursery class that he was taken out of?
No, it's after the church he was taken out.
It's after church? Mm-hmm. Kids running around?
Yes. Members are seeing each other, you know, tennis. I spent the whole church meeting with him on my laps, you know, in my arms. I was teaching a lesson that day, and after the sacrament, and I just let him go to the mom, to the mother. You know, and I waited for about 5 or 10 minutes, you know, talking to members. So when we were ready to go, my wife came back and said, "Where's Cody?" I said, "Look, he was with you." He said, "No." Then it happened. I went to the police reporting that, you know, we've lost a child. 35 minutes later, I went to another police department. Then my phone rang. Mm-hmm. The call came anonymous, you know. Then I hung up. Then they called me back immediately. Then I see the number. I told to the police officer, I said, look, there's a number that I know, just called me and asking me money for the child that I've just told you that I have lost.
How much money did they ask?
$150,000 they asked me first.
And what happened with that? Did you try to get the money?
Well, I give them 150 Haitian goods, which is about, at that time, $4,500. I paid as a ransom. I paid that money on two occasions. They never get the child.
And they didn't deliver. No. We come in the front door, we always do things above board. And we knew that if we wanted to investigate this Gardie case, we needed the support of the Haitian government. We needed that case file. We needed to open it up and pick up wherever they left off. And so we went to the police station to plead our case and to get support. We got in with the Inspector General, who runs the whole show, and basically just said, whatever you guys want, you're getting.
It could not have gone better. He pledged his full support. He told his guys below him, this is your priority for the week. Everyone drop everything to help these guys out. I believe in their mission. I love what they're doing. This is just the beginning. I hope that we can work together with them more in the future. I give you my full 100% unequivocal support. I mean, it was awesome. It was really, really cool.
The Haitian police actually made an arrest in this case. His name was Carlos. This is the guy who actually kidnapped Gardie and tried to ransom him off with some other thugs. We drove 3 hours from Port-au-Prince to La Caille, where Carlos was in prison, so we could interrogate him, and we did. We learned very easily that he was lying, that was obvious, but we didn't get any full confession. When Carlos gets into jail, he makes this woman, Amy Vros, his point of contact, his emergency point of contact, and they still believe that she had something to do with the kidnapping and trafficking of Gardie. So the logical step was to go in undercover and see what Evros is all about, to see what kind of business she was running.
Oh, c'est de la même? Oh, enfin. But yeah, this is your finish.
Bonjour.
Bonjour, Timonio. Mechita? Okay, she says, go ahead and have a seat. Okay. Wow. So she says, we seem to be careful. It's obviously a very sensitive thing. We need to be careful or else we can become arrested. She can become arrested.
She said that?
Yeah. Okay. Qui j'aimerais te faire ça? Si on était décidé pour faire dans l'autre genre. Okay.
She would sell us a kid like this. Yeah. Then we shut her down. I'm gonna leave it to the Haitians. It's ultimately their decision. So we went to the orphanage just now. We just got back. Uh-huh. She's like, I can do it. She's like, call me. Pick which one you want and call me. Maybe she did it with Gardie. We can stop her though.
Yeah.
What do you think? Do you think she
might have done that with my own son? Right.
But if she did, we can find That's why we need us get her, right? Yeah. We get her in the hot seat. Did you take the, is that what you did to Guardi? Did you traffic Guardi? What do you think? Do you like the plan?
I like it, I love it. I love it, and that would be a blessing for the people that are suffering over there. I know they're suffering.
I mean, let's face it, these kids that we're gonna save tomorrow, they are on the auction block. They're being sold. Any gross pedophile can come in and buy any of them. Any trafficker can buy any of them, like this. Look how easy it is. Here's some cash, take the kid out. Wow. Yeah, this will do. This will do. This is good. This is actually a great lookout because the arrest will probably happen right there. Where that truck is, that's where we talked about it happening. Hey.
Garrison, what's up, question?
Hi.
Oh, yeah. Hey.
Oh, hey, I remember you.
Yeah, here, let me just show him the roof so we can kind of get this lane. Montreux Deoa. De Machine Policio. Yo, ma'am, avec yo, ma'am. Epi. You have the okay, poco. And you have comme si you have to suivre pour garder yo. Depuis nous arrivons dans la machine, you have the allez non. Après une machine police qui vient comme ça, après un lot qui vient comme ça, et puis on a fait just way call the morning machine.
A sandwich.
Un sandwich, like a sandwich.
Yeah.
Okay.
So. Ben l'idée est des cadeaux. C'est non seulement au gain technologie, au gain moyen pour aider nous combattre. C'est un bon babo. Des cadeaux. Ça nous vient faire là.
Should we kind of go outside and just talk about where the undercover is going to be and show?
Yeah, let's walk him out and just kind of show him.
There's
the goal is to go straight from the orphanage with her in our car and coming directly here. When we called to confirm, she said, "Oh, one slight change. You know I told you $10,000, but actually I wouldn't even, I had to check with the other authorities. I don't know if there really are authorities, but the other directors, they said actually it's $15,000.
She's not doing much but collecting cash and selling kids.
In God's hands now. We are planned. We're ready.
Hello.
Hello.
Hey, little guy. Hi, Colin.
Yeah.
Hi, Colin.
Yeah.
Hi.
Oh, here. Say, ask her. You can't separate these two, can you?
He said, yeah, you could.
But that would be horrible, wouldn't it? Ask her. Tell her.
You put up trees.
That'd be so sad.
Mm-hmm.
She says, no, they won't be that.
They're brother and sister.
Did he mail for access?
That's like what do you mean?
He's like, that.
Are they healthy, all these kids? The ship?
Lydia's kids are in good health.
Yes.
All right, let's go. We gonna hit it?
As we were loading up, Ivros asked another lady to come along with us. It turned out it was her daughter. And I wanted to know what her daughter knew. And so I asked her if this was going to be a dangerous thing we were doing. And she stated unequivocally that absolutely it was dangerous. This was illegal, in fact, and that we could get in big trouble.
When are their birthdays?
We had a female undercover Haitian officer playing the role as our nanny, the lady who would come and take care of these kids for us as we took them out of the country. And Ivros came up with this idea as we were negotiating. She said that we should tell the kids that this Haitian officer, who was our nanny, tell the kids that her name is Mama. That is her legal official name, so that if officers were to stop us, At any point along our smuggling route, the kids would refer to this nanny as Mama, and somehow that would help us to get out. So when we count the money, they don't want the kids to see that. I'm gonna lay it out and you count in Creole, so there's real clear. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. Okay.
Okay, so we'll go, let's get out of here.
Maybe Thursday or Friday?
Police! Madame Couchet! What? Tout le monde derrière l'air. Police! Madame Couchet!
Dis-le, get down, tiens, get down. Everyone just get down. Get down.
Madame Couchet!
Get down. Put your head down.
Deux semaines depuis là, travail. Ok, je dis à la nous arriver et nous jouer. C'est Timon qui apprend. On a pas le temps de finir mon champ modèle là. Ok?
You don't even know how prevalent this is. Little kids this age being forced into sexual exploitation. Like, you have no concept of how real and how huge it is. How huge it is. There's thousands of people who do this, and they would love to get their hands on little kids like this. And they're this age, and they're this age. So, this is, and I fear that people won't understand.
Because she doesn't look like a bad guy.
What a huge problem is. They never look like bad guys. I've arrested dozens of bad guys. None of them look like bad guys. They look like you, they look like me, but at the end of the day, you can't traffic children.
No.
At the end of the day, there's laws put in place to protect kids, and one of those laws, surprise, surprise, is you can't sell them. Like, you can't sell human beings and put a price tag on them. And that's what these two people did. Both of them did it. Both of them knew they were doing it. They didn't know who we were. They knew us for an hour. Had no idea who we were. If you guys were traffickers, you'd come in just like this.
Toute autorité dans pays a cap travail dans baïsa connaît que aider l'équipe là aider nous pour nous.
All the necessary authorities know who we are. The judge knows exactly who we are. It's a process they need to do. Like, it's just a step that needs to happen.
Parce que une bagaille. La justice en Haïti, il faut des preuves.
In Haiti, you need to have proof.
OK. Et ça que fait, mon yo, juge la ou yo.
Yeah, that's part of the proof. The judge just
says that. Il contrôle l'argent.
He's the money.
200 billets de $100 américains qui baille $10,000 américains.
Just part of the
evidence. Et lui est des mon yo.
And he sees the kids. He sees okay. The
buyers. Ou vend 10 moun.
Sell the kid.
Et ou vend, mais l'argent.
I sell it.
Mais moun qui a pas acheté, c'est ça. OK, après.
You're here.
C'est yon moun.
Selon l'information que l'on a, et ça fait que le
Mugendo, according to all information I got, 20 moon notes. People are selling kids at the office.
Tout le monde pour qu'ils soient là. Mais même, bagage.
Oui, bagage. Non,
je
n'ai
jamais. Ok.
Loire et tout, en flagrant délit.
You're here because they arrest, you've been arrested.
Ou gen det se moun ke ou van.
That you sell two kids.
Pou 30,000 dola.
For 30,000 dola.
20,000 dola, ya bon 10,000 dola. Pe chak
ti moun ap 10,000 dola. They're gonna give you 10,000 dollars.
E ti moun yo, efektivman, lem de vin ambe de ti moun na, ou ti mse det ti moun sa yo.
I've seen the kids, I've just looked at the kids. To buy.
Ou te bay ti moun yo. Ou es yo kon blan yo, ou bay ou ti moun. Si yo te tou bala ti moun yo. Ça fait ça.
If you don't tell the truth right now, it's going to get worse and worse and worse for you.
Now I want to know why you get arrested.
I get arrested because I bought those two kids at the hotel and they give me money for them.
She said yes. I think she just said yes. I said I would sell the kids. It's quiet.
That's called trafficking in English.
It's completely quiet. It sounds emotional. It's just resonating what she just said.
J'étais là. Oui, il reconnaît que il vend des timonio pour 20,000 dollars. Il reconnaît avant ta menti, il est venu confondre. Oui, il reconnaît il vend timonio pour 22,000 dollars. OK, il reconnaît ça.
Finding Gardy is a miracle, right? But everything's come down to this point. Like, she's admitting that 5 years ago she did this. Right? There's a reason I feel like we're here. There's a reason, you know what I mean? There's a reason we got to this point.
Right.
Like, this is the pivotal moment right here.
Right.
Will she just say it? Will she say, yes, I sent Gardy. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, I think we should pray right now.
Let's say a prayer really quick. He's starting this thing.
Heavenly Father, we ask you to please, please answer all the millions of prayers that have gone up to find this little boy. If he is alive, and if she, if he first knows where he's at, please, please soften her heart so that she will reveal this information to us. We plead with you to hear these prayers and do all you can to influence her to do this. That we might follow through and find Gardy. And we say these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. He just asked, do you know Gardy Marty? The one that was kidnapped.
This is the time when you come clean.
On everything. Right now.
No more life.
No more lies. Right now, you can't give lies. We have all the evidence, everything. This is the moment for you.
Point us in the right direction. We won't send your daughter to prison.
You pap, they will be different for a reason.
She lied at first, and then she confessed. She said, yeah. We worked that angle. That's the angle we worked. And she was very distraught because she was already in such big trouble.
Where are the kids? The kids that they...
They were taken by the Yves, took them to a place.
Mm-hmm.
And now I'm going to go to Yves tomorrow because we have to go tomorrow to the orphanage and take all the other kids out.
Okay.
And when we go to the orphanage, we're going to look around still. They need to ask all the older kids, show a picture of Gardy. Do you see this boy? We're closer.
Yes, I think that.
You know we're closer.
Yes.
I was hoping so badly tonight would be the night. The next day, we went back to Evrosa's illegal orphanage with the Child Protection Services of Haiti to find evidence about where Gardy might be and also to get these kids out of there. We pulled back the curtain on this criminal enterprise and we were absolutely shocked at what we saw.
inhumane conditions, starving kids laying there in their own feces, just broken, broken children. We couldn't wait to pull them out and bring them to a place of light. Each and every one of these kids got pulled out of this place and were taken to a good place. A lot of them, a good number of them, ended up going to Gessner's orphanage, a place that we know is a place of light and righteousness. And we got to go visit them and be with them and see them be healed.
Bien y empezamos a salir. A los pocos meses yo me fui a vivir con él y cuando me pegó dije que ya no quería nada, o sea, no me había explotado, o sea, no me había sido trata en ese momento, era como un matrimonio entre comillas feliz hasta ese momento que me golpeó y yo decidí irme. Fue ahí cuando después me encontró y fue cuando ella me secuestró y fue cuando ella me empezó a poner a trabajar de eso.
The case in Colombia is different. The case in Colombia is dealing with victims who are already at that point where they're being sexually exploited. They're being forced into sex slavery. We're back in Cartagena. Our spirits are high. It feels much different than when we left last time. We're gonna save these kids. In fact, we're gonna save more than what we were going to last time. We're gonna get the ones from last time, about 15 more. We're very encouraged that this time it will work. This time we will be victorious. We've been in close contact with the team of prosecutors here in Colombia, and they're ready. They have their ducks in a row. They've done all the legal preparations necessary so that when these guys show up with kids, these guys are going to jail, and they're not going to get out.
There's a place in one of the street markets there where they openly sell child porn in Guatemala. Yeah, you just walk up and they got the video. Like here, you see the videos for sale, but these are just straight up child porn. And they do that because there's demand. People want to buy that. They want to buy that. And that's just, I mean, those people are going to be, you know, there's got to be another part in hell, extra special, just for those people.
Amigos! Bienvenido a mi hotel.
Hola.
How you doing? ¿Cómo estás?
Hey.
La otra vez, cuando estuvimos aquí,
sí.
En el momento más bajo, usted dijo algo.
¿Qué dije?
Que estaba avergonzado por su país, dijo.
Sí.
Pero me imagino que no, se ya. Siente muy diferente ahora.
No, es que cuando sentimos que no nos apoyaban y sí. Que los fiscales complicaban todo, no lo hicieron por mal, lo hicieron tal vez por hacer un buen trabajo.
Sí.
Y no me dio vergüenza decir con ustedes, venir, trabajar, sí. Invertir, hacer muchas cosas y que no se dieran las cosas.
Sí.
Pero hoy estoy feliz.
Sí.
No podemos fallar
no.
Y no vamos a fallar.
No.
No lo haremos. Estaremos muy bien.
Estás contento de ser colombiano.
Muy contento.
Yo también estoy contento de ser colombiano. Porque
está bien.
Ahora soy colombiano hoy y mañana.
Sí, sí. Queremos hacer esto para que todo salga bien, que el país quede bien, que sí. Demostrarle a todo el mundo que en Colombia sí trabajamos por esto, que queremos ayudar,
y
que queremos.
Realmente va a salir como la luz de toda Latinoamérica. Oh. Porque nadie
lo ha hecho.
¿Sí? Ustedes van a ser los primeros para como gritar al mundo, miren nosotros, miren.
Sí, estamos haciéndolo.
These traffickers actually will present these children in these catalogs, children who they are trying to sell for sex. When I see these kids in this catalog, it makes me want to do whatever I can to find out where they are, where they're being held, and throw all the resources we can to pull them out.
Él le dirá con quién va a estar. Oh, qué linda. Le va a gustar al jefe.
Oh, sí. Sí, sí, sí. ¿Cuántos años tiene?
Le va a gustar al jefe. Envíame. Envíame.
¿Eh? Oh, sí, 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 sí. Le va a gustar.
No la quiero para mí, sin jefe. Sí. No, yo la tomo. La voy a tomar para mí.
Es que ella puede venir. ¿Seguro?
Claro.
Oh, sí, sí. Es,
si no, yo la tomo.
Por eso venimos.
No la tomarás tú, yo.
Sí. Pero por eso venimos, exactamente, sí. Perfecto.
There's plenty of places to hide cameras in this room. It's just so important that we have just this place wired, audio, video, like, perfectly.
Ah, esta operación va a salir excelente. Yo le tengo fe a esto que va a salir bien. Esta vez vamos a irnos muy bien.
Sí, sí, esto va a ser seguro.
Mejor que la primera vez.
No, no, esta vez se va a hacer. Esta vez se va a hacer.
Thomas.
Thomas, good to meet
you,
I'm Mark.
All right, so what do we got? We got some new chickens?
Yeah, what is? I gotta go see these six girls tonight, okay?
Six chickens.
This guy had chicken heads. But they're supposed to be real young and pretty.
So you're talking about an extra eight chickens?
Yeah. So basically.
25?
No, it gives us 18 is what it does.
The girls that were there last time are coming again?
Yes.
All of them?
All of them are coming.
Because there was a couple of them that were nice. Mm-hmm. I'll call you later today and tell you where. We're gonna have you meet, split up into two groups. We don't want the whole town going, gee, where the hell is these 40 girls going?
Because right now I'm working on 18 girls. So, I mean, if you need more than that.
Of the girls that we already have that are sure, how many of them are actually minors?
We have seriously minors. I've got
nine.
Nine that are minors.
Okay.
What are the ages? I've got one 13, between 13 and 16 years old, I've got one.
Okay.
I've got one that's 13 right now. That'll make him happy.
Cool.
All right.
Peace. Be careful.
Nice to meet you. I'll call you tonight.
Good to see you. This should be a major. Talking 25 kids, 30 kids, and five, six guys going to jail for 30 years. It's a big case. If this works and the Colombian government is willing to let us do this stuff, there's lots of places to go here. Lots of places.
We're going to want a bunch of girls out in the courtyard.
Well, it's quinceañera.
Yeah, we're going to tell them it's a quinceañera. And they're going to dress.
We can have them, we make some signs, say quinceañera, they whatever name, and point in this direction, balloons on the house door.
That's totally what we're going to do.
Yeah.
That is totally what we're going to do. But we're going to make a sign that says, Feliz cumpleaños a María. We'll get some balloons.
Those girls can do that.
Yeah. So we're going to put that on the door, just in case. And that's for looky-loos outside who see 30 minors walking into a house. Thinking, oh my gosh, if they see a sense of happy birthday, that's a birthday party, you know, no big deal. This is a Colombian operation, first and foremost. I want to make that very clear. We don't have the authority on our own to do this. This is a Colombian operation, and they're the top of this. So I want you to understand how this is going to go down. So first, I'm going to tell you where the Colombian officers are going to be. Okay, so there's going to be six up in this room right where you're right now, staging. For outside surveillance, watching things from the outside, and who will also be in charge of making sure everyone gets out and gets to the rendezvous point. And two here, and then Andrew will be hanging out in this restaurant on the corner doing the same thing. The rendezvous point, which a lot of you know, is the hotel at the end of this street. Don't talk about that outside this room. So at 5:45, roughly, we're gonna make the phone calls, and they're gonna confirm, yes, we're here. And those three guys who are gonna go out and bring them in, and they're gonna usher the kids through here into the backyard. So we'll probably have seven bad guys arrested. That's the number we're shooting for.
We always have to have somebody covering the door over there and the stairs going up.
Cafe de la Mar? Yeah, if you go there, we're gonna come and meet you.
I just want them to know when the call was made. I'm just gonna do this. That means the call was made and like, in about 2 minutes, it's gonna, the breach will happen.
Okay, me llamas, 10 minutos, me llamas.
Everyone's coming in.
Hey. Amigo. ¿Cómo estás?
Bien.
Hey.
Hola, amigo.
Pequeña, le va a gustar al jefe.
Oh, sí, con los shorts.
Sí.
¿Cuántos
años?
16.
Ah, pero se ve.
Se ve.
Sí.
¿La más?
La foto, ¿tú viste la de
Pantaneta? No, no, no. Los shorts. Sí.
La camisa blanca.
14.
Eso es.
¿Y él dónde está? Siga.
No, él tiene que ir. Sí, sí, sí. ¿Cómo se llaman? ¿Cómo?
Está mi amigo, déjalo, está mi amigo.
Y una piscina ahí, comida también tenemos para ustedes.
¿Qué quieres? ¡Mesero!
¡Javier, Javier! Gracias.
Oh,
vamos. Mi jefe va a estar tan contento.
Sí.
¡Perfecto! ¡Perfecto! Yo no sabía si te iba a traer lo que decía, pero así es, amigo.
Y yo, Ismael, y conmigo, los paquetes completos.
Sí.
14, 12, bien. Ah.
Perfecto. Ah, perfecto, perfecto, amigo.
Bien.
¿El de 14?
Hey, ¿qué hace? Sí.
Ella hace todo. Con la camisa blanca.
Es. Todo. Eso, el bolso.
Sí. Ella hace todo.
Todo.
Ok.
Esto se puso muy bien.
¿Cómo estás? Hola, hey.
Hey, amigas, vamos a caminar en grupos pequeños para no vernos el grupo. Hey, vamos.
¡Bienvenidos a la casa! ¡Bienvenidos!
¡Hola!
¡Hola, muchachas! ¡Les están esperando!
¡Son amigos!
¡Hey!
Marcos, how you doing, man?
Hey, what's up? Oh, I speak English!
I'm from Florida, dog.
Oh, man, it's about time I got some English here, man. Hey, so, question for you. I was telling these guys when the boss comes, I mean, he's very respectful, of course, but he doesn't want to get into a bad situation. You know what I mean? I get in trouble, right? And it's happened before where he'll go, start, some of the younger girls, you know, start, trying to touch him, and they get scared, they're not, is that gonna happen here at all?
No, because what I did is, from what I was explaining that he likes, I did bring one that's young and for him to look at, for him to check out.
She's nice.
How old is she?
She's 14 years old.
And she's here?
Yeah, she's beautiful.
Look, can you point her out? Just point her out to me so I can see.
She's nice.
Are the other ones that age too?
Other ones, some are 15, some are 16.
But you got the one that's the youngest?
Yeah.
Okay. Which one?
This one.
Okay. Hola, 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 hola. Okay. 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 ¿Cómo te llamas? Okay. Okay. So she's 14?
Yes.
Okay, so here's the thing. Does she do everything?
I've talked to her.
Anal sex?
I told her anything crazy that he wants, if she wants more money, she better ask.
Oral sex?
Yes, all
anal
that.
Sex? No, there's not going to be any problem.
Exactly, I've talked to her.
And she's 14 for sure.
Yes.
You're the man. You're the man. Money time. This is the good part.
These are the two.
Pero cuéntalo para que quedemos bien. Okay. Hey, how many for him? ¿Cuánto?
$1,000.
$1,000 también. Está bien, $1,000. Okay, cuéntalo para que.
The girls are 300.
Marcos, what do you got, Marcos?
He's got 300 per girl. How many girls came?
15.
4.5 million plus his personal money, which is...
Okay, count this, because we kind of knew ahead of time, but I just want to make sure you're good.
Hay uno feliz, hay uno feliz, hay uno feliz.
Bien, estamos bien? Okay. Okay, estamos bien? Bien. Marcos, come on, man.
Dude, he's got too much to count.
Finish that up, man. You represent the United States, man. You're the slowest one. You're making me look bad.
He needs a calculator.
Everyone here? ¿Todos están?
Hey. Están muy bonitas.
Entonces, yo puedo llamar al jefe.
Sí, por supuesto.
Casi como 10 minutos algo.
Yes. Ya está, ya viene.
There's a movie tonight. Hey guys, you see the full moon out tonight? There's a full moon out tonight. I can't. Woo! Woo!
¿Quién es el jefe de ustedes?
¿Por qué partieron la puerta?
Se les van a explicar, ¿ok?
Sí.
El comandante del grupo de nosotros les va a informar qué es lo que está pasando. Pero por favor, que me colaboren con el silencio. ¿Entendido?
Dude, we're screwed.
No, we're not.
No.
Drinking cigars and smoke and drinking beer? Colombia, that's not against the law.
Dude,
they're gonna catch you lying, dude.
Okay, you think so?
Yeah.
I bet you $20 every girl here is over 18. Bet.
Okay.
Every girl here is over 18. I make sure of that.
I hope you're right, man.
I'm not worried about that. That's why I'm relaxed right now, dude.
Okay. Are they musical chairs? What's going on? And then there were two.
he's saying that they're all 18 plus. There's no way, dude. There's no way, right?
He's just trying his hardest. He's trying his hardest to, like, hopefully.
Right?
The other guy, his Leo.
Yes.
Yeah. Leaned over to me. He's like, okay, listen. The ones that are minors, like, we took their senators away. He said it to me. He's like, so they can't.
Yeah, there's no way. I mean, if that. Yeah. There was a couple of that, not all. I mean, there was a lot of them that I could tell were.
He leaned over to me. He's like, a couple of them are. He's like, the ones that are. He's like, there are. He's like, he was winking at me. He's like, dude, stop talking. Don't say that. Some of them, the ones that are minor, we took their IDs away. He said, so don't worry. Jeez, dude.
Yeah, that'll do it.
Yeah, we took them away. So don't.
We took them away.
He said at least four for sure. We took the IDs away.
But they wouldn't even have IDs if they were under 18.
Maybe their school IDs or something. I don't know. But they have a, I don't know.
All I know is I saw those girls, dude. And there's no way. No way.
He's like, here's Marcos, right? Marcos, hey, everything's great, dude. Don't even worry about it. Hey, you get me a lawyer. But no, we're fine, dude. We're going home tonight. Hey, you better give me a lawyer. An interesting element in the Cartagena case was the fact that the traffickers, in addition to the 12 and 13-year-old girls, brought these adult prostitutes who kind of hovered over the girls, kind of groomed them, showed them what they're supposed to do, and kept an eye on them. And these poor little girls are kind of mixed and mingled within this larger body of adult prostitutes.
Soy inocente de todo. Inocente.
Laurie was getting his, hey, what's your name and how old are you? They were playing the age games. Like, she was like, how old do you think I am? And they would say, and then she'd say, how old are you? And one girl says, well, I'm 12.
Really?
Yeah. And the other girl said, well, I'm 13. This one girl, we're sitting next to her, and I asked her, how old are you? And she said, I'm 18. And there's no way she was 18.
Yeah.
But she goes, yeah, I have a 3-year-old. And she said, look, here's my cesarean stuff. And she shows us her scars for a baby she had 3 years ago. She couldn't, I'm sure she was so small and so young, there's the only way she could deliver a baby.
Oh, yeah.
And there was no way she was no way.
She was.
No, and right now, and so I was surprised at how many of them, as we talked to them, they're saying, oh, yeah, I have two kids. And these babies are having babies.
Yeah.
Even the ones that are saying, yeah, I'm 18, and I've got a 7-year-old and a 4-year-old.
Nah. On the heels of the arrest, the government of Colombia, their child protection services, marched right in and took charge of these kids. We're a rescue operation, but the rescue doesn't really get completed until these kids get rehabilitated and healed. And the process begins right away. We make sure the process begins right away, working with government authorities, and also with, in this case, a private organization called Rey Nacer that comes in and identifies these kids, tries to find their families, and begins the healing process for these children, which is a very difficult process. For us, we leave. And it hurts, because we leave with these girls thinking that we were these sexual predators. But that just comes with the territory of what we're doing. Great success here, but we've got so much more to do. We can't celebrate too long. This problem is everywhere. It's in every country. It's in every city, and so we have a lot more work to do. The search for Guardi continues. I promised his father I would never give up, and I never will. Whenever I finish one operation, I immediately think, what am I doing for Guardi? News of our success has traveled pretty rapidly. So many countries are now asking for our help, and we're active. to Haina to do some follow-up work. And as usual, we bumped into some people who were the vendors, people who would lead you to traffickers. Yeah, do they do any enforcement down here?
Yes, big trouble before this guy from the state. I wanna f*** the small girls, man. It's not good.
When did that happen? ¿Cuándo?
No, it's impossible.
Pero esto, this happened before?
No, before sí, un problema muy... You speak Spanish?
Sí.
Eso fue un problema que tuvieron, eso es un peligro, chicas menores de edad.
¿Cuándo? ¿Cuándo hicieron esto?
Hace como 2-3 meses atrás.
Sí, ¿qué pasó?
Se estuvieron con chicas menores de edad.
¿Quiénes fueron?
Llegó. No sé, I don't know.
¿Fueron americanos?
Americanos.
¿Americanos vinieron?
Americanos, sí. ¿De dónde son ustedes?
¿Cuántos fueron arrestados?
I don't know, pero sí, bueno, entendí más o menos un problema. Pero no sé más. Chica menor de edad es no good. Big trouble.
Yeah.
Aquí las chicas en el bar. Hookers. Let me show you.
No.
Nah, está bien.
Okay, man.
Ahora estoy muy contenta, estoy casi a 10 días de entrar a mi escuela de belleza. Es algo que me gusta, me apasiona, algo que quiero, y con el tiempo quiero tener mi propio salón de belleza. Después de eso quiero estudiar turismo porque me gustan los idiomas y ese es mi sueño. Y pues ese es mi sueño. For the future, I want to go to college and be an English teacher.
Yo ahorita estoy a punto de entrar a la universidad. Voy a estudiar enfermería y estoy súper feliz. Porque voy a hacer la diferencia. Tal vez no en una atrás de una Cámara de Diputados o algo así, sino en el hospital. Porque ahí yo llegué golpeada y no me atendían. Entonces, así como. Es lo que yo quiero lograr.
Schindler's List basically tells the story of a man who, in the end, made a difference. And he spent his entire fortune, which was a lot of money. But he spent every dime saving Jews. If I were to make a statement, the parallel would be the individual and how one person can make a tremendous difference in the lives of other people. The Holocaust, we can do nothing about. That's now history. Today, we're on the forefront of another Holocaust in its own way. In our own way, we can step up. We can get the word out. We can contribute money to it, to other people that are making that effort, and do what we can there to stop it.